Hello, welcome to the Methuen Memorial Music Hall, home of the great organ. I'm Matthew Bellocchio, president of the Music Hall Board of Trustees. The winter is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time of the singing of birds is here. And the voice of the great organ is heard in the music hall. This year, we're celebrating the 75th anniversary of the acquisition and incorporation of this building as a nonprofit educational and cultural center and our 75th summer recital series. I'll tell you more about our history during the intermission. This recital is the first in this year's 15-week series. It is sponsored in memory of Richard A. Kenney, who was a longtime recital sponsor. Sadly, he died last year from COVID-19, but Richard's friends are honoring his memory by sponsoring this opening recital. We'd like to thank them and all our sponsors whose generous support is making this year's recital series possible. And we invite you, our viewers, to visit our website, mmmh.org, and look for the donate link to help support the music hall. Thank you. Tonight's performer, Michael Hay, is Associate Director of Music and Organist at St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City. He's also a well-known concert organist. In 2017, Michael won first prize in the Shanghai Conservatory International Organ Competition. Thanks to the generosity of a friend of the music hall, the great organ has recently received some much-needed attention. Decades of dust have been cleaned from the organ's interior, and all the flue pipes have been carefully re-regulated. Thanks to this work, the great organ now sounds even greater, and Michael's program tonight will make the organ sparkle for our diamond anniversary. He will tell us about his pieces. We hope you enjoy this program. I'll see you at intermission.
Good evening. Welcome to everyone who's watching tonight. We're here at Methuen Music Hall in Massachusetts on this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful instrument with lots of work done to it over the summer, as you heard. So it's such an honor and a privilege to be playing this instrument and with new ears for the first time, too. I started out with a piece of French music by Eugène Gigout, and it's so funny to just basically be alone in this hall right now. And to be playing for people who unfortunately aren't here today in person, but with the great, wonderful added ability to watch online on YouTube and for people all over the world to tune in and hear this wonderful instrument. So I'm going to continue on the French route now, and I'm going to be playing three pieces by the French composer Maurice Ravel. Ravel did not write anything for organ, so these pieces that you're about to hear are either written for piano or for orchestra. And although he didn't write anything for organ, it's, I would say, indisputed that he influenced the French school of organ playing greatly in his compositional style and his harmonies and his musical forms. So this wonderful French composer, Maurice Ravel, I'm going to be playing two movements of Le Tombeau de Couperin, the first and the third of my set. And in the middle, I'm going to be playing the Pavane for a Dead Princess. And we have a very special edition here today. It is kind of funny to be playing organ to an empty room, but like Stephen Colbert would do on, you know, a late show or any late show, Stephen Colbert, I heard on the news, he has his wife sit there. So I actually have my wife sitting here too, and she'll be joining me for the Ravel Pavane in between the Prelude and the Toccata. So I hope you enjoy these three wonderful works by French composer Maurice Ravel. three works by one of my favorite composers, Maurice Ravel. And now for another little bit of modernism. This is minimalism, actually, by living modern composer from the UK, Jonathan Dove. He's well-versed in the choral school in the UK, and he also has written a lot of choral anthems, operas, instrumental music, you name it. So he's written this wonderful piece of music in the year 2014 called The Dancing Pipes, and you'll see why. Hope you enjoy Jonathan Dove's The Dancing Pipes. One of my greatest pleasures is to keep the tradition of organ music alive and play new music and contemporary music. So if you don't like that one, though, we got something else for you to close off this half. And this is by Charles-Marie Widor. This is the Allegro from his Symphony No. 6. Lots of fun. And actually, someone asked me yesterday if I'd be playing Widor on this program, and I said, no. He said, oh, this organ's great for Widor and great for Vierne. And it just suddenly clicked that, yes, I am playing Widor on this program tonight. So thank you for asking. Your wish is granted. This is the Allegro from Widor 6, using the organ as a symphony orchestra. So I hope you enjoy. And please come back for part two.
Wow, what a great first half. Now, about our history. As many of you know, the great organ was originally built by the E.F. Walker firm of Ludwigsburg, Germany, for the Boston Music Hall and dedicated in 1863. Sadly, just 21 years later, in 1884, it was evicted to make room for the new Boston Symphony Orchestra. But in 1897, Methuen millionaire Edward F. Searles, who had an interest in pipe organs from a young age, purchased the great organ at auction and built and had noted architect Henry Vaughan design this beautiful building to house it. This architecturally and acoustically stunning private concert hall was dedicated in 1909 as Serlo Organ Hall. After Searle's death in 1920, the property passed through several owners, including the famous American organ builder Ernest M. Skinner, who owned the hall and the adjoining organ factory from 1931 to 1942. It was here that Skinner built his famous organ for the Washington National Cathedral. But during World War II, the U.S. government banned the manufacture of new musical instruments. Skinner defaulted on the mortgage and ceased operations in Methuen in 1943. In a short while later, the organ factory was destroyed by a fire. But the hall survived with only smoke damage. In May of 1946, 75 years ago this month, a group of Methuen citizens acquired the hall and incorporated to operate it as a nonprofit educational and cultural center. They renamed it Methuen Memorial Music Hall and set about raising funds to renovate, remodel, and maintain the organ, the hall, and the property. On June 4th, organist Arthur Howes, a music faculty member at nearby Phillips Academy in Andover, presented an introductory concert in the hall. But by that time, the organ had many dead notes and missing pipes, so Howes played just three organ pieces, and Australian pianist and composer Percy Granger, who was concertizing in the Boston area at the time, played two sets of piano pieces. The program was played twice that day, both times to a packed hall. A few days later, the local newspaper announced the proposed restoration of the organ that would, quote, not only make possible the presentation of excellent concerts by distinguished artists, but will also open up an almost unlimited range of other musical possibilities, end quote. 1 month later, on July 8th, the trustees signed a contract with G. Donald Harrison and the Aeolian-Skinner Organ Company of Boston to restore and revise the organ. The rest, as they say, is history. For 75 years, the Music Hall has brought music and musicians to Methuen with the summer recitals. Last year, during the COVID lockdown, we brought music from Methuen to the world through our YouTube channel. And we're doing it again this year. We hope to safely reopen the hall to the public later this year. But even when we do, we'll continue our online programs. The music hall and the great organ are becoming a cultural resource for the world. We hope that all of you will help us on this amazing journey. During this challenging time, we are grateful to be able to continue presenting these programs. The music hall is supported through generous donors and sponsors. If you'd like to help support us, please visit our website, mmmh.org, and click on the donate button. Or you can send a check to the address we'll show at the end of this concert. And even if you can't donate, you can still help us by liking and sharing this video and by clicking on the red subscribe button. Thank you. We hope you enjoy the second half of this program.
Call this part the American half. We're going to start off with something that couldn't be more British, though. This is Elgar's Pomp and Circumstance. But for a lot of reasons, I do want to put it on this part of the program because, first of all, we hear it at graduations, especially around this time of year. And second of all, because Edwin Lemare, the gentleman who transcribed this orchestral work for organ, emigrated from the UK to the United States and lived in San Francisco, so there is a little bit of a connection there. So I'm going to kick off this half, which features American music, with Elgar's Pomp and Circumstance. So congratulations, graduates. Now for a piece of American music by Dudley Buck, who actually lived up here in this part of the country. He wrote music in the European style because at this time in American history, the music was not quite up to par with the European, so they thought. So they imitated the style a little bit here. You can hear kind of the style of Mendelssohn, sort of that wonderful, lush 19th century organ sound, which this instrument does absolutely perfectly. And for all we know, it could have been performed on this instrument, perhaps when it was originally in the Boston Symphony Hall, or maybe it's been performed on this instrument before, I don't know. But it's written for exactly this kind of instrument, especially after the work that Frederick MacArthur has done to really make this organ sound more glorious than it ever has been. The other night, he received an award, this rosebush down here, which I have no idea if it has to do with The Last Rose of Summer or not, which I'm about to play, but he received this rosebush, and I can't remember what it was called. They said it was like a kicking rosebush or a crazy rosebush. I have no idea. I can't remember right now. I'm playing a lot of notes. My brain is kind of frazzled, right? So this rosebush was dedicated to Frederick MacArthur, who spent the pandemic voicing and cleaning this organ to make it sound better than ever. And this variation's on The Last Rose of Summer, perfect for where I work at St. Patrick's Cathedral. This beautiful Irish tune has been arranged, not arranged for organ, but has been composed as a theme and variations. So right off the bat, we're going to hear the song, The Last Rose of Summer, and from there, the organ is going to take it away.
Thank you.
another piece of American organ music, this time by Seth Bingham, 20th century composer who taught composition at Yale and also held positions at churches in New York City. So it's perfectly appropriate, I think, to play this on this wonderful American instrument here at Methuen. This is his roulade, or roulade, I guess, if you want to say it that way. It's fun, it's cheeky, it shows off a lot of the different sounds of the organ. And, well, sit back and relax and enjoy this little roulade by Seth Bingham. And switching gears to a wonderful new piece of music by a friend of mine who I met at Juilliard, Nare Sol. This piece, Solitude, written in 2020, I think speaks volumes. I think we can all relate to it somehow. And so it's actually really exciting to be here and be doing this broadcast because hope does spring eternal, and we will soon be able to go to the concert halls again. We're going to fill out auditoriums. We're going to hear the Methuen organ live and in person and not just through our speakers and smartphones. So it's actually a really exciting moment. And so I'd love to play this piece, Solitude, a wonderful new piece of music by my friend Nare Sol. And I'll get to the Sowerby after that. But first, Solitude. It's important in life, and especially as an organist, to breathe a little bit. So thank you again, Nare, for that piece. And We'll conclude tonight's program with another great piece of organ music. Kind of feels like the Roaring Twenties, and is a bit of Tin Pan Alley. Another theme and variations, this is by the Chicago composer Leo Sowerby. This is called Pageant. It's fun. It starts with a fun introduction, and you hear the theme played in my feet, and you'll hear lots of things actually played in my feet. So hope you enjoy Leo Sowerby's Pageant. I want to thank everyone for tuning in. I'd like to thank the committee of Methuen for hosting me. I'd especially like to thank Matthew and Frederick, Richard, everybody, and all the people here that have made this organ possible. I mean, 75 years of organ concerts in this spectacular hall with a spectacular instrument is quite a feat. So it is such a privilege to play here, and I'm just happy to use this as a vehicle to share my music. I couldn't have a better vehicle, I would say. So hopefully we can all see this instrument in person when things open up. And in the meantime, I'm just grateful that people are able to tune in from all over the place to watch this concert and listen. So I'm going to conclude tonight's program with Leo Sowerby's Pageant. Enjoy.